So in this tutorial, we're going to look at how we deal with direct and inverse proportion. They're basically dealt with in the same way, which is why I've only got one tutorial on them. So when we come across a question, what we're going to do is we're going to identify the two things we're working with. I'm going to call them A and B in my key points here. In this first question, let's just have a look at that. We've got y and we've got the square root of x. So those are my two things. We're going to choose the type of proportion. That's normally very obvious from the question. Is directly proportional to or is just proportional to means that. And we use the formula A equals k times b, where k is a number we're going to find. And if it says inversely proportional or varies inversely as, then it's inverse proportion. And we use A equals k over b. Now k, you may have heard called the constant of proportionality, which is quite a good name for it. But whatever, we're going to find k using the values we're given in the question, like that. And then we write down a formula for A in terms of B, whether or not they ask us to. They will sometimes ask us for a formula, sometimes they won't. They won't, but we will use our value of k. And then we simply use the formula to find out what it is we want to know. So a bit to do, but it's actually quite a straightforward process. So here we go. On this first one, as I say, identify the variables. So y is a, and the square root of x is my b. And so I've chosen the type of proportion. It's directly proportional to, there it is. And so I can write down that y is equal to k times root x. That's a equals k times root b. And then find k using the values in the question. So I'm going to use these values here. And I'm going to put 8 equals k times root 4. Well, root 4 is just 2. So I'm going to divide both sides by 2. And the root 4 cancels with the 2 to give me k equals 4. Okay, because 8 over 2 is 4. And so we can say y equals 4 root x. Now, they may ask us for that in one part of the question, they may not, but whatever, I'm now going to use that to put to find the value of y. So I can say x equals 25 gives me y equals 4 times root 25. Root 25 is 5, and so y equals 20. There we go. Let's do another question, and you won't be surprised to see that this one is inversely proportional. This time our a and our b are v and the cube of r. That's not the cube root of r, but r cubed. We're given a pair of values. We're not asked for the formula, but we're going to find it anyway. So v, if I get the right pen out, v is equal to k over r cubed. That's the formula a equals k over b with my a and my b. Put the values in. So that's r equals 2 and v equals 6. And I get 6 equals k over 2 cubed. Well, 2 cubed is 8. So multiply both sides by 8. And I get k equals 48. Which gives me a formula of v equals 48 over r cubed. And then we're asked to find the value of r this time, not the value of v, but the value of r when v equals 0.75. So I put that in and I get 0.75 is equal to 48 over r cubed. And however I want to rearrange that, I'm going to use a little blue triangle. If you see my tutorials, you'll know I like these things. Okay, and I'm just going to put in 0.75 is 48 over r cubed, like that. So that's what I've got there. 0.75 equals 48 over r cubed. So what does r cubed equal? It equals 48 over 0.75. Okay, you could have done that with the formula above, but equally well to do it with the numbers. So r cubed is 64, that turns out to be, and so r is the cube root of 64, which is 4. And we have done the question methodically, and it's turned out to be quite straightforward.